up, guys? Welcome back to Pat Outdoors. I apologize if I have not been posting new content in the last 2 weeks. I have actually been on vacation, but today I'm gonna be hopping back on one of my older projects that I have just simply not touched in a while, and that is my black and orange Razor MX650. In case you're new to my channel, this is my 52 volt Razor that goes 39 miles an hour with its current setup, which is a Kelly controller, which has been tuned by Electron Co. A Vever 1800 watt MY1020 motor that originally came with my 48 volt kit. Voltage step down converter to run 12 volt accessories such as my headlight. And then I just pulled the battery out to use for my E325 project. But today we're actually gonna get this thing back on the road. I simply have not touched it. I haven't had any drive since I got in my car accident a couple months ago. It's actually still all muddy from being mounted on the hitch carrier when I spun out on the parkway. But we're gonna be putting this Amorge 72 volt 20 amp hour battery, which has 100 amp peak BMS, into this thing. So we're converting this to 72 volts to get even more speed. A lot of y'all have been asking about my TTR QS138 project and why I haven't made a part 3 yet. And that is simply because I'm changing the setup. I was gonna use this battery on this, but I've decided I want a little bit more power out of this thing to be closer to my YZ250, which has a 40 amp hour, 350 amp peak BMS installed. And I'm thinking that this simply will not put out as much power as what I'm looking for on this thing. So I'm gonna be buying another battery for this, but this should be plenty to get this thing running to 50 miles an hour. Dang, I probably should not have wasted all that tire. My buddy Freddie just invited me to go out for a ride after work. So hopefully this thing holds air for the rest of the night. Kind of wanted one of these, but I ended up ordering something else recently that is also 60 volts.
Just realized one of my coworkers ate shit on my bike and the mirror completely broke off, but whatever. Oh man, this thing's pretty quick. That noise is from my rear freewheel. It's showing its age, it's on its way out. It only makes a noise obviously when I'm off throttle. I'm using a Psych Plus GPS based speedometer to measure speed, but it's currently not reading. It just takes a couple minutes to pick up the GPS signal. Thank you. I was able to beat that Cabo scooter going uphill. This thing goes over 50 uphill. That's nuts. What's up? Yeah, I went 51 uphill.
I hit 52 after the hill.
Okay, that's wild. Dude, that's freaking crazy.
Ride safe. Yeah, it's up to go a mile, 1.1 miles.
Dude, look at that spoiler.
Oh yeah. All the downforce.
Later, bro.
Missing you.
All right, let's see what the top speed is. This thing is crazy. Woo! This thing consistently does over 50. It's freaking nuts. With this 72 volt battery. BTR battery pack that I'm using for my blue bike. Wow. This thing is certainly a lot more capable of delivering power. Sitting at 79.8 volts after ripping on it for a couple miles. This thing is transformed with the 72 volt battery. This is nowhere close to the 52 volt setup. This is actually faster than my blue bike now, which is kind of insane considering it's my second bike that I don't really touch that much. The official top speed for the black MX650 is now 51.2 miles an hour. So it's definitely exceeded our build goals. And this thing is now turning into one of my main bikes. So I might be throwing some more parts at it. Well, if you enjoyed today's video, do me a favor and hit that like button. And if you like this kind of content, want to keep up with some of my projects, such as this Razor or any of my Yamahas, consider subscribing to this channel. But this is going to be it for today. Thank you for watching.